I'm so excited.
Me too.
How do you feel?
I am pumped.
Oh my God!
It's important for me to find a dress today here at Kleinfeld's because my timeline is kind of cutting it close. I'm getting married in 5 weeks.
There's a lot here. We're handing it over to Hashem. Gotta hand it over to God.
I am Orthodox. And in Orthodox Judaism, we tend to date rather quickly because I already kind of have an idea of what their value system is. From meeting Ben to actually like realizing in myself that he was like the right one for me was probably about 5-6 weeks, I would say. Pretty quick.
Okay, so I'm gonna take Melanie to show her a few dresses.
Yay! Yay! My dream dress that I would imagine would be sparkly, vibrant, princess, queen kind of glowing look. I'm not so into like the tighter mermaid look. My budget today is $8,000.
So I have four dresses here.
Okay.
All different.
Okay, let's start with, I like this one and this one.
Great, excellent.
I want my wedding dress to kind of be like awe-shocking, that when Ben is going to see me for the first time in my wedding dress, I want him to be like, oh my goodness. I met Ben through a matchmaker. We call it a shadchan. And we went out and the rest is history. He is very positive and loving, and he has totally devoted his life towards Torah, towards the Jewish lifestyle. And it's something that I really, really respect and admire.
Make a right turn.
Okay.
I'm so excited for Melanie because she's gonna get to touch her fiance for the first time. Many Orthodox Jewish women and men will touch for the first time under the chuppah at the marriage ceremony. So we need to dress quickly because, you know, it's time. Things are getting antsy over here. Well, let's get started. Which dress would you love to start with?
I think I like the sparkly dress.
It's great that you brought the shell.
Today I'm gonna be wearing this shirt underneath all of the dresses, so that way I will not be revealed today. Oh my gosh, this is so pretty.
Turn, like the princess.
Ooh.
All
that
sparkly.
Oh, I love it. Will it get looser at all?
You don't want to breathe. One day we have to step up for beauty. This
That's
is
what
the
we
day.
Do. I agree.
Okay, ready?
Ready.
Get out here, girl.
Oh, oh, here come the giggles.
Oh my gosh.
Oh. Oh.
So
I see sparkles.
I see you.
Oh my gosh. I love the sequins on this. So pretty.
It's so really.
I love the tulle.
Oh my gosh. You're like a princess.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel? I think it's gorgeous.
It's funny.
You said you wanted to look like a princess.
This is princess.
Turn around. Let's see the back.
Give us a twirl.
Oh, beautiful.
Stunning.
Oh. The part that her sleeves are, what would that look like?
So the lace combination, this is the bridal lace. And this, if you see closer, this is the sequence lace, will be on top of the base lace. It'll go down. You're gonna do a 3/4 sleeve or a long sleeve?
I'm not sure, I guess we'll see.
Okay,
we'll
so I always tell customers that if they're not sure, start off long. And at the fitting, you can make it shorter.
Okay.
You can't make something longer.
That's true.
Do you know what you look like? You look like a cake topper.
Like it's a little too puffy. You can make it less puffy.
Cause that's bothering me.
Like, it looks like her hips are really big.
No.
You don't like it?
Oh, Lord. Everyone knows that a gather dress is...
It's like...
It's
okay.
Dress. No one will think those are her hips.
I want it to be flat.
There's one layer of crinoline that's very gathered that I would take out so that this would lay softer.
Right.
I think the gather is what gives this.
But it won't be dramatically...
But you couldn't do more than that?
Not with this dress, no.
My sister was kind of hesitant about this first dress, which kind of threw me off because I didn't think that she would be the one to kind of have a hiccup on it. Off to the next
She
one.
Said maybe to the dress.
I liked it.
It was just a little too wide. The hair made her hips really big.
It's really important to put your feelings and your initial emotions in the forefront of your thoughts, pleasing the audience, not an option.
Yeah,
it's just not the time.
under the circumstances, we will not settle. This is her day, and this is not the time to be a people pleaser.
Oh my gosh, I love the tool. So pretty.
This one's long.
It fits you very nicely.
Yeah.
Like, it's perfect fitting.
I feel like the first one, like, screams a little bit more of, like, me.
Yeah.
You know? The sparkle and the lace and the beading.
The waist area doesn't stick out as much.
Like, what bothered me in the first one, this one doesn't have that.
Right. Is there any sparkly tulle fabric that, let's say, we could put on the third layer?
Absolutely. That's actually a really good idea.
Here comes the bride, all dressed in white.
I like the look of this dress. It's just missing something on the bottom.
So this is not her dress, but it's similar to this.
This is similar.
That makes a big difference, that extra shimmer. That
gives it that pop.
Yeah.
That looked really pretty. But I'm still kind of tossing up between the first dress and this second dress.
Oh my gosh. Aww. It's so good.
This is complete.
Oh my gosh.
My friends and all my family are telling me they all loved it, but how do I feel? That's what really matters. I'm not sure. I still really like the first dress a lot.
We should go back to the first to back these two. She's feeling like she's giving something up, and why should she give something up if she saw something that has what she wants, the factors that she wants? We're the only ones comparing.
Right.
If someone loves someone so much and they see how happy they are, it's respectful and appropriate for them to turn towards the decision of the bride. Walk out right here to the pastel. I'll tell them to come very quickly.
Yeah, just tell them to come.
Rather than put what they feel as a priority.
I feel like this is just more, a little bit more me.
The only part that I don't like about it, it makes your hips look like they're tent.
I don't see that.
Putting this dress on for the second time gave me this clarity that this was it, but it's gonna be kind of challenging to get everybody on board.
Wow, okay.
This is chalukei deos, you know what I'm saying? Like, everyone's gonna have
their own opinion.
I like this one better than the other one.
I'm surprised to hear you say that, actually. Because I feel like you were more against this one before.
I definitely don't think it's a bad option. I just had some things that were bothering me a little bit, but maybe with alterations, it will get it perfect.
I feel like a princess in this dress.
And do you see yourself walking into the Kabbalah's Panim room?
Yes, I feel like Ben will be like,
speechless.
My beautiful Kala.
I'm crying.
Oh, there's the beard.
It's beautiful. I love
you.
It.
I'm verklempt. Oh my gosh. In Yiddish, there's this word beshert, and it literally means meant to be. When you find the one, you know. You just know. And she knew. I have never seen a happier girl.
I feel like a princess inside this dress. I feel like it was just perfectly made for me. The amount of sparkle and detail that's inside of it.
Oh, Mel.
Wow.
Mel, can you believe it's real?
No.
So, Melanie Solomon, are we saying yes to this dress?
Yes to the dress! I'm like on cloud 9. This is the dress, and I'm about to marry my future husband in. I'm so thankful to Hashem, to God, for giving me this wonderful opportunity.
Oh,